Did you know that a heat pump can be 300% more efficient than a traditional gas boiler? That's good news for reduced sunshine in the winter. So you can use PV to contribute to winter home heating. And if you have no PV and buy the kilowatt hours from the grid during the night and store it, cost can be even competitive to natural gas. Welcome back to the channel, Supporters of the Climate. Today and next week, we are going to settle the debate once and for all. Heat pump or gas boiler? Which is better for central heating? If electricity is 30 cents per kilowatt hour and natural gas costs 10 cents, then the typical 3x multiplication factor of the heat pump is clearly creating break-even. But if you can use energy tariffs during night and store the energy for a few hours, you might pay even less, and you do the society a favor by consuming the electricity during the hours that it is difficult to sell the available production and grid capacity. And finally, you have a backup in the case of a blackout, which is easy to run in that case off grid. As I promised in video 68, among others, we'll be connecting our thermal energy storage, or TES, also to a commercial fan coil unit. And I have also built a do-it-yourself heat blower using a car engine cooler. They are just alternatives to the central heating with radiators. They are basically the same thing, but the latter is a cheap do-it-yourself solution and costed me 20 euros. These solutions distribute the heat or cold quickly into your rooms. Yes, I include cold, because this whole system with the heat pump and the thermal energy storage, the TES, is useful for the winter and the summer. However, in winter it can be hard to find a useful application for the cold. Okay, if you really want to discard it, you will be pleased to know that blowing this cold away will help the heat pump to give more heat for less electricity. That is indeed the force of this double storage. The heat pump likes very much to have these two rather constant temperatures that you can have only with large amounts of water. Last week, I calculated the average multiplication factor of consumed electrical power against the heat and cold, which we produced at the same time. You remember, I waited too long and got low values. So the heat pump was giving less heat and cold per kilowatt hour of electricity. Now I did a new experiment and will show this multiplication factor at a few realistic delta T values. That is the temperature difference between the hot and cold sides of the water box. It shows how efficient the heat pump can be when it has not to work too much. I also promised to try out central heating with this setup. It was difficult to complete it this week with our 40 years old central heating. But I bought all necessary components and am good on my way for the next week. Here's a sneak peek of what is going to come. So stay tuned for our full walkthrough next week. Anyway, I show you also a lot in today's video. The first time that you will see it running with two heat pumps at the same time for increased power. A measurement of the power and the consumption of the heat and the cold from the storage with a commercial and a do-it-yourself fan coil. I show you also how to get rid of the control unit and the two fans of a mobile air conditioner. We will see this after my, let's say, mission statement. So allow me to let you know what drives me, and I hope it will drive you too. As the world says goodbye to fossil fuels, which are a form of stored energy, and going to increasing electrification, storage is becoming a key element of managing this electrical energy. even at the household level. Homes that have their own storage are better prepared for the future and can even handle a blackout with ease. I am offering you here a much cheaper option than batteries. I know that electricity can run many more devices than my heat pump and thermal energy storage. After all, you cannot run a television on hot water. But heating and cooling together are a big part of what electricity is used for on a global scale. Therefore, I think that heat and cold must be put directly into a thermal storage and not in expensive batteries. I even say we need both. In addition to this storage, I offer unprecedented efficiency thanks to the heat pump. Unprecedented because I propose to use both sides of the heat pump. Commercial heat pumps use only the cold or the warm side in summer or winter. I replace the or with the and. Good old heat pump, invented 190 years ago. I made this week a special playlist for it and see that I have already 35 videos about the heat pump. Regarding the storage part of my configuration, that will make it easier to find an application for the heat and the cold, shifting the usage of one of them to another hour or another day. With climate hitting back, I've coined a new word. You see, in Dutch, we say to save one's own skin or je eigen huid te redden, indicates the strong human incentive of self-protection. And that's exactly what we need in the future. Let the insecurity about the future be our skin incentive to get careful with energy and a lot of other things. And I want to help you to turn this skin incentive into real working energy systems. The kind of systems that you will not find in the store, but you can make them yourself. I'm really grateful for the fast-growing interest in my channel. Your support means the world to me, and I'd love to do this activity full-time, but I also need to make a living. So if you enjoy this video, please hit the subscribe button and share this video with your friends. And let's go on with the improvements in the setup of the last week. One of the challenges I had the last week was the water separation between the hot and the cold compartments of the water box, in addition to the heat insulation between them. The water was just flowing through the polystyrene wall and even pretty fast, which is also very bad for the thermal insulation capacity of this wall. In this video, I show again how to keep really apart the cold and the warm water so that the insulation wall stays dry. I could not find well-fitting narrow and high water containers for each of the two heat exchangers, and want also to avoid that you have to look for them. Maybe in shops that sell narrow bins for waste separation or cutting an old jerrycan. I just started this way to divide standard objects like this cubic box for draining rainwater. Next, let me introduce you to the double heat pump system that I've been working on. Both independent heat pumps can run in parallel. Like the other system, also this small heat pump is now free from its control unit and fans, becoming really compact. This allows me to switch on one or two of them, depending on the availability of excess PV electricity or heating cooling demand. Yes, also cooling. Remember that this system is useful for winter and summer. And there it goes. Yes. Here's the air coming out. Here's where everything comes together next week. This is all I need to combine the thermal energy storage with the central heating, allowing to say goodbye to the heating with fossil fuels. We will have soon one single high efficiency system that works both summer and winter. So if you want to see more, make sure to subscribe and come back for the next week for a continuation of the video, where we connect the central heating system. For now, you can take a look in the new and really big playlist of the heat pumps.